Hi, my name is Margaret. In this video, I'm going to talk a little bit more about inheritance and polymorphism. I want to start by looking at assignments in combination with superclass and subclass variables. So let's assume class A is my superclass and class B derives from class A, so class B is my subclass. Var A is a variable of type class A. I just refer to it as a superclass variable, and var B is a variable of type B. I will refer to it as a subclass variable. Now, one possibility would be that we have a variable of type class A and we try to assign another variable of type class A. So you can see superclass variable gets assigned another superclass variable. Just to be very clear here, var A is a superclass variable because we declare it right here as such. We declare it as a variable of type class A, which is the superclass. This, of course, is not a problem because assigning a variable of a given type to another variable of the same type always works in Java. Different possibility is to have a variable of class A and try to assign a variable of class B. So here I have a superclass variable. I want to assign a subclass variable. Once again, this is no problem because the subclass is a superclass. So assigning an instance of a subclass to a superclass variable works just fine in Java. Third possibility. I have a variable of type class B and I want to assign a variable of type class B. So I have a subclass variable, try to assign another subclass variable, and analogous to the situation one, this is no problem because I'm assigning a variable of a given type to another variable of the same type, and that always works in Java. Now my last combination is trying to assign a variable of class A to a variable of class B. On the left side, I have a subclass variable. On the right side, I have a superclass variable that I want to assign to my subclass variable. And you can see there is a cast in front of it. This is necessary because not every instance of the superclass is necessarily an instance of the subclass. So it requires an explicit type conversion. The explicit type conversion, of course, is my cast, and we talk here about downcasting. So when you treat a variable of the superclass as an instance of the subclass, you call that downcasting. Before the variable A, we have a cast. We explicitly convert the type from the superclass to the subclass. This is like telling the compiler that we are confident that the superclass variable is indeed referencing an instance of the subclass, so it can be treated as such. When you cast, the compiler trusts, but the runtime checks. So yes, it will compile, but during runtime, the true type of the instance that var A is referencing is going to be verified. And if it is of type class B, everything works great. If it is of a type that is incompatible, then an exception will be thrown. Let's look at some examples. Let's say I have an animal, A1, and I assign it a new bird. I can do that because a bird is an animal. And now I create a new variable, my bird. It's of a type bird. And I want to assign it the variable A1. I cannot do this directly because A1 could also be a different animal. So explicitly I'm casting it to a bird. In this situation, this works fine because A1 is indeed an instance of a bird. We just initialized it with a bird instance right here. This cast will compile and it will run just fine. Let's look at another example. Animal A2 gets assigned a new fish. And now here, once again, I create a variable myBird and I want to assign it A2, cast it to a bird. At runtime, the true type of the instance referred to by A2 is going to be verified, and it will be found out that A2 is actually referring to a fish. That's what we are assigning right here to A2. So when we try to cast it to a bird, this doesn't work. A fish is not a bird, and an exception will be thrown. Third example, I have animal A3, and I just assign it a method. It's called getSomeAnimal, and this method returns an animal. Now here I'm trying to cast A3 to bird. We don't really know what getSomeAnimal is really returning, besides that it is an animal. If it happens to be a bird, it will work, otherwise it will not. Of course, we try to avoid unnecessary exceptions. It is nice to be able to check whether a variable can be converted. One way we can do that is by using the instanceof operator. The instanceof operator ensures that the instance is of a given type. So here is an example. If animal A3 is getSomeAnimal, I can check if A3 instance of bird. Here I'm checking whether A3 is indeed an instance of a bird. If that is the case, I can safely cast it to a bird and assign it to a variable of type bird. If A3 should be null, let's say getSomeAnimal returned null, then the expression returns false because null is not a bird. Now let's have a look at dynamic binding, also called late binding. All calls to overridden methods are resolved at runtime. Now let's look at the example we've used before. Here is my animal, and I assign to my animal a new bird. And now I'm calling my animal move. You can see my animal is of type animal. However, during runtime, it is established that my animal is referencing an instance of a bird, and because of that, the move method of bird is called, not the move method of animal. So it's the move method of the instance that is referenced, not the move method of the type of my variable. Now I'm going to add one more class to my inheritance hierarchy. I'm adding a songbird that derives from bird. So my songbird has only one method. It's a new method. It's called sing. It does not override move, but it adds the method sing. You can see I declare a variable my animal of type animal, and I instantiate it with an instance of songbird, which I can because a songbird is a bird, is an animal. And now I'm calling my animal.move. The type of my variable is once again animal. The question is which move method is going to be called. So during runtime, it's going to be established that the variable my animal is referencing an instance of type songbird. But songbird does not override move. So we're going to look one level up, the parent of songbird, bird. Bird is actually overriding move. So the move method of bird is going to be called. So let's say we know that my animal is referencing an instance of songbird, so we want to call my animal.sing. But that won't even compile. It does not work because my animal is a variable of type animal, and animal does not have a method called sing. If I want to call sing, I have to cast it first to a songbird. I have to make sure that I'm accessing my sing method on a variable of type songbird, because only songbirds know how to sing. So if this cast in front of the dot operator looks a little bit confusing, you can also do that in two steps. You create a variable sb of type songbird. I just used a very short name because of my space restrictions here. And you can assign it, my animal, cast to a songbird. So here in this line, I am doing a explicit type conversion for my animal. I'm very confident this works because I just instantiated my animal with an instance of songbird. So I'm casting it to songbird. Now I can assign it to a variable of type songbird. And now that I have a variable of type songbird, I have no problem calling sing because songbirds know how to sing. In this video, I'm going to build on the animal, bird, fish inheritance hierarchy we built already in the polymorphism video. And now we're going to add yet another class. It is called songbird. And songbird derives from bird. So bird is the superclass, songbird is the subclass of bird. If you look here, you can see songbird does not override move, but it adds a new method called sing. So here, I'm going to my songbird. I'm going to create sing. It's public, it's void, it's called sing. And I'm going to have a print statement, system out, print line, singing. Typically, we want to separate display and functionality. This is an exception here in my introduction to inheritance of polymorphism. I print in my bird class and in my animal class just to be very clear where different functionality comes from. Let's check back at animal. Animal's move method is implemented as moving. Bird's move method is overwritten as flying. The fish move method is overwritten with swimming. Songbird does not override move, but it adds a sing method where it prints singing. And now we're going to create an animal called my animal, and we're going to assign a new songbird. And at this point, I want to say my animal move. I'm going to compile and run, and you can see what we get is flying. Even though my animal is a variable of type animal, the move method is not the move from animal. The move method is the move from bird. I'm going back to my UML class diagram. You can see songbird derives from bird, derives from animal. We always go up the inheritance hierarchy until we find the first implementation of a given method. So in this case, move is already implemented in bird, it's overwritten in bird. So this move method is going to be chosen rather than the animal move method. Which particular method is going to be called depends on the instance we're referencing, not the type of my variable. Now I also want to demonstrate the attempt to call sing right here. So I know my animal references a songbird. I know my songbird knows how to sing. And if I try to call sing on my animal, I get a message here and it says the method sing is undefined for the type animal. Because my animal is a variable of type animal, I can only access animal functionality. In this case, the only method I can access is move. I cannot access sing. If I want to access sing, I need a variable of type songbird. So one way to do that is to cast my animal. I can say songbird, and to make sure it gets casted before the dot operator is used, I need to add an extra pair of parentheses. So at this point, I can compile and run, and it tells me singing. Because now, on the left-hand side, before my dot operator, I have a songbird. A different way to write that is to split it up in two lines. Let's just delete that and make a songbird variable. I could say I have a songbird, my songbird, and I'm assigning my animal cast it to a songbird. So here I'm using a cast songbird. This is an explicit type conversion. And I say my animal should be accessed as a songbird. I'm very confident this works because I just initialized my animal with an instance of my songbird. So at this point I have a variable of type songbird, and now of course I can use this very variable to access the sing method. And if I compile and run, I get the exact same result. It prints singing.